I'm really excited to be here. I think this podium is a little too tall for me, though. Hello. Thank you for inviting me here to talk to you about my project, Staging Voices for Change, which, as Allison just mentioned, looks to create a piece of theater on the topic of violence against women based on the lives and experience of women who live in Cape Breton. This idea didn't come together suddenly. It stewed for a while and bumped about with other ideas before coming to the surface. My undergrad thesis looked at the depiction of violence against women in contemporary plays. It wasn't the violence on stage that bothered me. Some of the most heart-wrenching scenes were the most powerful. It was how the violence was depicted that I took issue with. For example, plays that created one-dimensional female characters who faced violence allowed an audience to see them only as victims. It dehumanized the women on stage. My research found that this stock pity was not useful in showcasing the realities of violence. If theater looks to create change, it needs to engage its audience. We need it not only empathy versus simply stock pity, but texts that did justice to this violent reality showed women as survivors, not victims. This helped an audience to not see these women simply being defined by the violent acts being done on them, but instead seeing them as women who are able to overcome and survive this violence. These texts were narratives of empowerment. At the same time, I was directing the Vagina Monologues and hanging out with Sarah Kate at Cape Breton University. V-Day, the organization headed by Vagina Monologues author Eve Ensler, is a global project that looks to end violence against women. I worked with 15 amazing women, and our discussions at rehearsals were incredibly insightful, leading me to wonder what a piece of theater tackling issues in Cape Breton would look like. V-Day ran a campaign alongside the Vagina Monologues called 1 Billion Rising, based on the fact that 1 in 3 women in their lifetime will face violence throughout the world, amounting to 1 billion women. As I worked on the project, women in my life began to talk to me about the violence they had faced in their own lives. As much as that statistic, 1 in 3 women can stick with you. It was these stories from peers, colleagues, friends that took root in me. Because statistics are hard-hitting, but can be dismissed, placed away for inventory to think about or forget about. But these stories from people that I loved and respected could not be unheard, could not be dismissed or erased. So this spring past, I decided to write a play about violence against women in Cape Breton. It came at a time when much debate and discussion had erupted in Nova Scotia. The suicide of Rehtaeh Parsons captured the attention of the world. It came to light that Nova Scotia has the highest rate of sexual assault per capita in the country. It also became apparent that we still needed to have a lot of conversations concerning rape culture that you would think would not be needed in 2013. I was angry. I was tired of talking about it. I wanted to do something. With the help of Dr. Jody McDavid at CBU, we organized 4 community consultations, 3 at the Every Woman Center and 1 at CBU. The goal was to speak with women about their concerns relating to violence in Cape Breton, ideas that I would showcase on stage. Women did not have to have experienced violence to take part. Any woman who was concerned with the issue was invited to come. Through smaller discussions and really great facilitators like Allison, we talked about issues the community faced that prevented women from seeking help, that allowed these issues to persist, and what our community needs to do for change. And we hope to publish a report, actually, in the winter time that will be accessible to everyone with these results. My hope is to mount an initial production this coming summer, either as a piece I write on my own or potentially a collaborative piece, in part based on these discussions. I believe a piece of theater that wishes to create change must allow its audience to do 3 things. First, to recognize. To see the women in the stories as people and not simply victims, not only empathizing with the characters, but considering how these stories can empower us more than simply a statistic. Second, to reflect. for an audience to engage with the piece, not only on a personal level, but to realize that the stories on the stage are a reflection of their community, of an issue that exists today in stories that are based on the voices of women in our community. And finally, to react. To engage an audience is not enough. Education, important. Discussion, important. But we must consider ways in which we can create change through action, whether in local leadership or in our individual lives. And I think of what Allison was saying, of taking ideas and turning them into doings. This type of theater cannot offer a solution, because if I knew the answer as to how we would end this violence, I would simply tell you today. A theater for change must foster an environment for consideration, for discussion, for growth, for action, for transformations. And seeing the stories based on the voices of women in the area, it is my belief that theater will provide our community with the opportunity to see the devastating narratives that play out in our communities again and again. It will allow us to acknowledge that we have the ability and the responsibility to change these narratives and to ensure that violence against women in our community ends. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to me today. As was mentioned, if you would like to follow the project, you can check out the project's blog at theconsequenceofsound.wordpress.com. And I will end with this little bit. At the end of each session, we invited women to write a slogan or an idea that they felt would create change in our community. I leave you this evening with three of their voices. One, you matter. Your experiences matter. You deserve respect and love and to be listened to. Two, we will change things together. Three, it is time to rock the boat. Thank you very much.